Warm greetings from the High Ten. It is Everyday Shenanigans on the Sunday, October 11th, 2020. If I made a mistake and said yesterday was the 11th, because I made some videos yesterday, excuse me. When I started doing stuff back-to-back, I started getting confused myself. So pardon the wrong dates. I think from now on, I probably should just stop giving the dates because YouTube airs the dates of the videos when they are uploaded. But anyway, hello to everyone. I hope you all are well. The Queen is doing good today. God willing, thank you. Amen. Thanks for the kind words and prayers. Okay, I want to talk about O.J. Simpson and Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman. And right now, there is a documentary that aired on the ID channel last week on October 5th. Please log on over to the ID channel and watch the said documentary if you would like. And also, there is a documentary airing about the evidence pertaining to the O.J. Simpson trial of Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman, and that is a 6-part documentary also airing, and you can watch both of these said documentaries on your cell phone if you don't have cable or don't want to, you know, watch it on TV. But anyway, I want to bring you the said information, and I'll talk to you a little bit later about the said documentary. This source is by Food and Everything Else Too, Food, Entertainment, and Politics. A new documentary on ID channel, Secret Diaries, reveal the horrific abuse she suffered. In a slew of unearthed journals belonging to Nicole, who was killed in 1994, document in detail up to 60 different incidents of alleged beatings. Nicole Brown Simpson's diaries will be made public for the first time in a new documentary, which airs on Investigation Discovery on October 5th, about her relationship with O.J. Simpson. O.J. and Nicole, an American tragedy, a 2-hour Investigation Discovery special, will coincide with the 25th anniversary of Simpson's acquittal in the infamous murder case. Nicole Brown Simpson's sister, Tanya Brown, is speaking about the aspiring photographer's murder and her relationship with her husband, O.J. Simpson. Her entries detail the alleged physical and mental abuse she suffered at the hands of O.J., who was acquitted of the killing of Nicole Brown and her friend, Ron Goldman, in 1994. In one scene from the upcoming Investigation Discovery film, Tanya said, according to the Mail, maybe she knew this was her destiny, and maybe subconsciously she knew something was going to happen. Maybe that's why she kept real detailed diary entries. Nicole wrote about 60 occasions that Simpson allegedly physically abused and threatened her, including their stormy marriage. In scratchy handwriting, she wrote how he beat her up in 1978 and punched and kicked her in her hotel room for hours while she tried to escape. For the next 16 years, the abuse included flipping out into a jealous rage and smashing her car up, throwing her against walls, and repeatedly leaving her blackened and bruised. In the documentary, former LAPD officer John Edwards recounts going to Simpson's house the following year and finding a badly beaten Nicole after she called 911. He said, a woman came running out, a tall blonde woman, and she was yelling, he's going to kill me. I said, who? She said, O.J. I said, O.J. Simpson? She said, you've been up here 8 times already, and you've done nothing about it. During his testimony at Simpson's trial, Edward said that Nicole collapsed on me and was wet and shivering. She was cold, and she was beaten up. Nicole had a cut 1 inch on her left upper lip, a swollen right forehead, and a right eye was starting to blacken. Edwards told the jury, I could feel her face. She had a mark like a hiking boot. She looked like she'd been kicked in the head. I looked over my head, and here comes O.J. Simpson right to where the gate is, and he's yelling. I mean screaming. I don't want you around here anymore. I got 2 women. I don't want you around here anymore. Simpson was arrested for spousal battery and later pled no contest to the charges. And that is the said information from this site that I've never heard of called Food and Everything Else Too, if you need verification for the said information. And everything basically I repeated to you is in the said documentary, and I can verify that because I watched it last night. Let me start by saying, oh, mercy. It was a very interesting documentary. I've always been intrigued with true crime. Most of you know that who have followed me for the past year on this YouTube channel. I want to say that at the time when Miss Nicole was murdered and Ronald Goldman, because I do not want to leave him out because he has gotten the lower end of the storyline over the years, and people tend to focus more on the suspect than the actual victim. So let me also say, Ronald Goldman and Nicole Brown Simpson are the victims in this said storyline. When the case unfolded, it was brought to the public. Of course, I was shocked like many people. I followed the case up until, I guess, probably before I had moved out of the Knoxville area. Didn't have cable at the time, so I didn't get to follow up. But then I resumed in the fall when it was time for the verdict, because I was at work at the time of the verdict. I was ecstatic that he got off. Yes, I was. I was happy because I thought, you know, this is a crazy trial. Everything came out about that Mark Furman. And honestly, I'm going to tell you this. I did think at some point during the trial that OJ was guilty, let me say, only because of the blood. Naturally, that was the evidence that they had. The glove at the scene. The blood on his truck, outside his truck. Droplets, I believe, inside the truck. Blood outside the rear bumper of the truck, leading into the gate and the driveway of the said Rockingham address. The bloody glove on the south wall thrown over, disposed of, dropped, whichsoever, however you want to word it. Those things were odd to me. I believe there was also, but this was not mentioned in this said documentary that I watched, that there was blood inside the house upstairs in the bedroom where his socks were, or some blood was in the socks, if I'm not mistaken. Those were things that bothered me then. Like, why would he have blood outside his truck, inside the truck, outside the driveway? But when the Furman tapes were released, the interview he had with the screenwriter who had been interviewing him, that's when all hell broke loose and many Americans concluded that if this Mark Furman could easily call black people niggers, every word in that tape was nigger this, nigger that. You can't believe the word of a nigger. Every 5-6 sentences from a nigger's mouth is a lie. Why would any sane person think that OJ killed this lady and this man, his ex-wife and her friend, acquaintance? Because once you lay out the picture of a racist cop, the same cop who is on and or leading the investigation of this homicide, plural homicide, why would I think that he did not plant the glove, plant the blood? And I think that's where a lot of people's minds venture towards, is that, hey, this guy don't like black people. He's let this be known. He has let this be known in a said interview with a woman. She recorded him, and she ends up testifying in the court to the fact that this man used this said information, and this is why she brought forth the tapes. We probably would never even heard those tapes had that lady not brought forth those tapes. And at that time, she probably thought, hell, I'm helping O.J. Simpson. She didn't know O.J., just like none of us knew O.J. Many of us never knew he beat that woman, that he was a jealous man, that he was jealous of her thereafter the marriage, that he had been stalking her thereafter the marriage. How would we know that? Now, I'm an older person than I was in 1994. I was a 23-year-old female. Not a dummy, but a young person. I'm now 49 years of age. I've weighed this story in my head a few times, and after watching the documentary last night, I feel like I have recently. I do believe O.J. Simpson murdered Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman, because looking at the blood outside the truck, the Bronco, out on the ground, behind the bumper, leading into the drive, the bloody glove found on the property, it would have been a lot for these people to have to take blood and do what? Go to the scene and rub it on the truck, drop some blood going into the driveway. You see where I'm going with that? Now, naturally, OJ put on that glove, which sealed the deal. He put it on with a latex glove, and it didn't appear that it fit as a good wearing glove, a good fitting glove. And let me tell you, OJ Simpson had huge hands. I noticed that in a picture in this said documentary where he has his arm around, I think it was Nicole. And you could see this man had fingers and nail beds that were just huge. So he was not a small man. His hands were not small. One could argue, well, the glove shrunk because it was wet, and it's sliding evidence, plastic bag, paper bag until trial, so naturally it's Trump. Look at it however you choose. I'm not here to argue with anyone about the murder of these two innocent people. I'm just giving my commentary that thereafter the trial, as I got more information, as I started pondering things, I realized one day, years ago, I said, O.J. Simpson killed that woman. He had no remorse. He had no remorse for beating her during the marriage. He had no remorse for sleeping around with different women. He had no remorse for stalking her thereafter. He had no remorse. And when you listen to the 911 tape and you hear him screaming at her and making obscenities about her having oral sex inside of her home, and obviously he knew that because he viewed her, he probably was standing in the window 9 times out of 10, so he watched her, if that allegation is true, of her having some type of sexual interlude with the man. How would you know that? How would you know that? Some people rumored, you know, that she was dating Ron. I don't know. That's never been proven. It really doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who she was dating, because at the time of her death, she was a single woman. She was not a married woman. And over the years, and this has nothing to do with the documentary, because this said information is not mentioned, what I'm getting ready to say, the issues of drugs, drug use, drug hit, her affairs with acquaintances of O.J. Simpson, in the end, none of those things came to fruition, and no other suspects were ever brought forth. The only suspect brought forth in the said investigation of Ronald Goldman and Nicole Brown Simpson's murders were O.J. Simpson. It's a sad tale. When you listen to her sister, Tanya, read the diary, it's sad and it's disturbing that this lady, you now see, continued to date him knowing he was abusive, married him, set up shop, house with him, had children by him. Why? 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 The sad part is that when he met Nicole, he was still married to Marguerite. So you see, it's no telling what he was doing when he was married to Marguerite. I never got the 411 on how he treated Marguerite and or if he had affairs while he was married to her, but nonetheless, he did meet Nicole in the said restaurant where she was working, / bar, and they resumed a relationship, and then thereafter married, had a family. It was sad hearing that the children were in the house at the time of the murder. Baffling to know the two children were inside while their mother was being bludgeoned to death, she and her friend. Do you understand what I'm saying? Very sad. Listening to the detective, the police officer, talk about the children at the police station thereafter, the little girl, Sydney, wanting to know, hey, when am I going home? When is my mommy going to pick me up? Because this is a school night. She had no idea that she would not be seeing mommy, that mommy was deceased and killed by her own father. This documentary lays out the relationship between Tanya and the children as a date. She does not have a relationship with Sydney, which is terrible because she believes that, you know, Tanya hates her father. But she does, Tanya, have a relationship with the son, which is good, very good. But all this is so baffling, even now, years later, the anniversary of the acquittal, O.J. Simpson, that after the fact, after this killing, many of you know about the hotel situation of him running in with his friends, associates, to get his set memorabilia back from a guy, two men who were selling the memorabilia, all that mess, him getting 9 years for that, for armed robbery. I remember watching him in the court years back, and I actually felt something for O.J. Simpson, and I told myself, why are you feeling anything for this man? You know in your heart he killed those people. But it was something about him sitting there looking like a sad puppy dog in court, making his plea so he could be free. And I told myself, that's how all this mess started. That same puppy dog face, that same charisma, that same woe is me is what got him in these failed relationships and marriages, going on trial for murder, for killing his wife and her friend, going into that hotel room with guns or whatever, who did what, said what, who pulled out a gun. Nonetheless, he was charged. Associates charged. Some got off. But you understand what I'm saying? Some people have charisma. Some people have charm. And that's why a lot of people who are known as narcissists and sociopaths get away with things. Because they are liked by many people. They are favored by many people. So they get off on said behavior. And I think you know this from all the stories I've brought you with about famous men who have done heinous crimes with women and children, rape, sodomy, vulgar commentary, and mistreatment of said females. Because they were liked. They were revered. And no one wanted to believe that these people are actually sinister human beings. But they are. And that's something I've learned about people in general. A lot of times we don't want to believe the worst in a person. So naturally, an icon such as O.J. Simpson, known to be world-renowned football player, who would want to think he murdered this woman and this man? Why would he do it? But what you also have to ask yourself, who would gain from the death of Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman? Who would gain from their death? And now, many years after the fact, watching her sister read her diary to the public, you see the fallout of a sad and pathetic, pointless relationship she had with this man. But she loved him nonetheless. And she even wanted to make it work thereafter the divorce. And finally was done a month before her actual murder. So naturally, once he realized he and Nicole were not getting back together, the wheels started spinning. I don't know if he planned this murder, spurred a moment, a month before, a day before. But one thing I will say, I find it interesting that he decides to kill this woman and man right before taking off on an airplane flight to Chicago. The fact that he did jimmy back to California once he was called and notified that Nicole had been murdered. The fact that his middle finger had blood on it, fresh blood, while he was being interviewed, pictures were taken. And they asked him about the said cut on his finger. He basically says he don't know how he got it. See, anyone with common sense knows that when you have a bad cut, a deep cut, it will continue to bleed because it has been cut deep into the skin. And it has been known that when a person has been stabbed multiple times, that the suspect will injure him or herself in the act of stabbing the victim. And that's what happened with O.J. He stabbed her and Ronald so many times that he injured himself. And that was his blood on the walkway of her Bundy address. And that was his blood walking from the Bronco to the driveway. You understand what I'm saying? O.J. Simpson cut himself while stabbing those two victims. And he had a fresh cut, and the pictures are obvious, because there's blood on his hand at the time of his interview. And where would you get blood from? You would have it bandaged up, but it's still bleeding naturally, because it's a fresh cut. You see, those are the things that people probably focus on at one time, but as I say, when Mark Furman came in, and testimony came in about him being racist, and using derogatory comments, calling African-American people niggers, all that was said as far as evidence pertaining to O.J. Simpson and blood matter did not matter. And I believe that is why those 12 people found O.J. Simpson not guilty. Furman sealed the deal with those tapes, making derogatory terms about African-American people, so the jury was fed up. They were done. And I watched a documentary about the said jury, and those people were damn near fighting each other in the said room trying to deliberate about this case. And I mean, they were acting out, acting a fool, because they wanted off the trial, they wanted it to be over with, and it is known that when people start bickering and fighting and can't come to a conclusion or an agreement, they start to become numb and shut down. Because they are tired of being in the jury box and trying to come to a conclusion and to try to get other people to come to an set agreement. I do believe the jury was tired, and I do believe they went ahead and said, the hell with it. Let him go. Furman's a racist. He's a racist cop. We don't know what this man or other cops did. They could have planted the evidence, the blood. Who knows? Let's just go ahead and free OJ. That's what they did. Please tune in to the ID channel for the 6-part documentary pertaining to the evidence, according to OJ Simpson. I will be watching that. You can also go to ID channel to watch the said documentary and or watch it on your phone. This documentary I'm talking about right now, An American Tragedy, is airing right now on the ID channel. It aired last Monday. It is a riveting tale, once again, of the storyline of OJ Simpson, Nicole Brown Simpson, and Ronald Goldman. You do not see any other members giving commentary in the said documentary but Tanya Brown. I always felt like her sisters and family were tired of talking about O.J. Simpson because they knew that man had killed their child, their sister, and Ronald Goldman. Everyone knows it was a $33.5 million judgment, civil suit awarded to Nicole's family and Ronald Goldman's family. The family owns the rights to the book that OJ wrote. I believe the title was changed, and that it was to recoup money for the judgment. OJ is a narcissist. He's a sociopath. He will never admit what he did. But one thing I've learned about killers, they will talk to someone, they will let their guard down, and they will tell someone what they did. It's just a matter of who's going to be the one to come forward and tell what he said. Because I don't think you can walk around and hold that in. And I think about him over the years now, before he caught that armed robbery charge, how can you walk around, be around his children, knowing he murdered their mother and her friend? I wondered, after the fact, being free a few years ago from the armed robbery charge, he was paroled. I also just wondered, how could he walk around? Why don't this man have any remorse for killing her? How could he walk amongst people and his own children knowing he murdered that woman and her friend? It's a sad tale. And it's a sad tale of a woman trying to hold on to a relationship that was never there. There was never any love, because there's no way you can love someone and beat them at the same time. There's no way. And it's sad that even in the end, after divorcing, she still tried to make it work with O.J. Simpson. And did she know he was going to murder her? I don't know. Why did she live minutes away from him? That bothered me, because I thought to myself, if I feared for my safety, would I buy a house close proximity to the person who's been beating me for years? But I think she may have done that because she had those children by him. I think really she should have moved up the coast where her parents were, because I think the farther away was the best way, especially when you're dealing with a person with a violent temper and a vile tongue. And O.J. Simpson definitely has a vile tongue. Is he changed? Has he redeemed himself? The only person who knows that is O.J. Simpson and God. Thanks for joining me. Please check out O.J. and Nicole, An American Tragedy, on the ID channel, and also check out the 6-part documentary pertaining to the evidence to O.J. Simpson and the trial. Like, share, subscribe, drop your comments below. Thanks for joining me. It's a dreary day in the high 10, but I'm here, and I'm grateful to be above ground, honey. Thank you so much. Hello, Martha. Shiny V, where are you? I haven't heard from you, honey. Let me know you're all right. You all mask up, stay safe out there, and this is Everyday Shenanigans. Let me know what you think of the said documentary and commentary, and if you didn't watch it or don't want to watch it, just let me know if you think O.J. Simpson murdered Nicole Brown Simpson and Ronald Goldman. Everyday Shenanigans. I'm out of here. Thanks for joining me. Bye-bye.